How Usain Bolt, the fastest man ever, totally transformed the world of sprinting. What's the secret behind Bolt's jaw-dropping speed? How did he manage to shatter records and leave everyone in awe? In this video, we're going to break down the science behind his incredible performance and explore what makes Bolt's sprinting style so unique, ready to uncover the magic of speed. Let's get started. But first, let's rewind a bit and take a closer look at Usain Bolt's incredible journey to becoming the fastest man on the planet. It all started in Jamaica, where Bolt was born and raised in a small town called Sherwood Content. From a young age, he showed a natural talent for sports. His parents, particularly his mom, noticed his energy and enthusiasm, and they encouraged him to channel it into running. Bolt first got into sprinting during school days. His tall frame and quick reflexes made him stand out in local track events. But it wasn't just his physical gifts that set him apart. It was his sheer determination and love for the sport. As he continued to compete, he began to attract attention for his speed and charisma he had on the track. Fast forward to the early 2000s, and Bolt's name was starting to get noticed in the world of athletics. But it was at the 2008 Beijing Olympics where Bolt truly made his mark on the global stage. Before Beijing, Bolt had already made a name for himself in the athletics world, with impressive performances at various events. But the Olympics were a whole different ballgame. At the 2008 Games, Bolt burst into the limelight in a way that few had ever seen before. In the 100 meters final, he broke the world record with a time of 9.69 seconds, and he did it with what seemed like ease. Bolt famously celebrated his win with his iconic "To the World" pose, making it clear that he wasn't just another runner. He was a showman who knew how to captivate an audience. But Bolt didn't stop there. Just a few days later, he competed in the 200 meters final and set a new world record of 19.3 seconds. His performances in Beijing were nothing short of spectacular. People weren't just talking about the records he broke. They were amazed by his ability to dominate races with such a unique combination of power, speed, and showmanship. He was now the face of sprinting, and his impact on the sport was undeniable. His performance at the 2008 Beijing Olympics set a new standard for sprinting. It wasn't just about running fast. It was about doing it in a way that captured the imagination of fans around the world. Bolt had redefined what it meant to be a sprinter, blending extraordinary speed with a charismatic presence that drew people in. Now that we've covered Bolt's incredible journey to stardom, let's dive into what makes his sprinting so special. The science behind sprinting is pretty fascinating, and understanding it helps us appreciate just how remarkable Bolt's achievements are. First off, let's talk about the physiology of sprinting. At the core of sprinting speed are muscle fibers. There are two main types, slow twitch and fast twitch fibers. Slow twitch fibers are great for endurance, but aren't as fast. Fast twitch fibers, on the other hand, are the real stars of sprinting. They contract quickly and powerfully, making them essential for explosive speed. Bolt's muscles are packed with these fast twitch fibers, which is a big reason why he's so incredibly fast. Another crucial factor is biomechanics, the way our bodies move. When you sprint, your body has to coordinate a lot of different movements to maximize speed. This includes the way your legs move, how your arms swing, and how you push off the ground. Bolt's running form is almost like a perfect machine in motion. His stride length is exceptional. He covers more ground with each step than most sprinters. This is partly because of his height. He's around 6 foot 5 inches tall. Being taller gives him a longer stride, which means he can cover more distance with each step, adding to his overall speed. Genetics also play a significant role. Bolt's body is naturally designed for speed. His long legs, tall stature, and lean muscle mass all contribute to his ability to run faster. Not everyone is born with these traits, but Bolt's genetics give him a distinct advantage on the track. But it's not just about natural talent. Bolt's success is also a result of his intense training regimen. He didn't get to the top just by relying on his natural abilities. His training was incredibly demanding and precise. Bolt worked closely with his coach to develop a program that would push his body to its limits while minimizing the risk of injury. A big part of Bolt's training involved sprint drills to improve his start and acceleration. Starting from the blocks is crucial in sprinting, and Bolt practiced this to perfection. He also did a lot of interval training, where he'd run at top speed for short distances, followed by periods of rest. This type of training helps improve speed and endurance, by pushing the body to adapt to high-intensity effort. Bolt's strength training was another key element. He focused on exercises that built explosive power in his legs and core. Squats, lunges, and plyometric exercises like box jumps were part of his routine. These exercises help in generating the force needed to propel his body forward at such high speeds. Additionally, Bolt's flexibility and agility were enhanced through stretching and mobility exercises. Being flexible helps with stride length and reduces the risk of injuries. His training wasn't just about running fast. It was about making sure every aspect of his body was optimized for peak performance. It's like Bolt's sprinting success is a mix of outstanding biological factors, unique physical attributes, and a rigorous training regimen. His fast-twitch muscle fibers, biomechanical efficiency, and genetic advantages come together with the hard work he put into his training. This combination not only made him the fastest man ever, but also redefined what's possible in the world of sprinting. Now, let's break down some of the key techniques that made Usain Bolt stand out on the track. It's not just about raw speed. Bolt's approach to sprinting involves some really specific techniques that contribute to his incredible performance. First up, let's talk about Bolt's starting technique. The start of a sprint race is crucial because it sets the tone for the rest of the race. Bolt's explosive starts were one of his trademarks. He used starting blocks to get a powerful push-off right from the gun. The way he positions himself in the blocks is almost an art form. He'd crouch low, with his weight balanced perfectly between his front and back legs. As the starting gun fired, he'd push off with immense force, propelling himself forward in a way that gave him a significant advantage over his competitors. This explosive power off the line helped Bolt build momentum quickly, setting him up for a strong race. Moving on to his running form, Bolt's technique was also a major factor in his success. One of the most striking things about his form is his stride efficiency. Bolt has a very long stride, which means he covers more ground with each step. This long stride is partly due to his height, but it's also a result of his technique. He maintains a smooth, powerful motion with minimal wasted effort. His legs move in a rhythmic, fluid motion, which helps him maintain speed without tiring too quickly. Another important aspect of Bolt's running form is his arm movement. When Bolt runs, his arms swing in sync with his legs. This isn't just for balance. It actually helps to propel him forward. His arm swing is powerful and coordinated, helping to drive his legs with each stride. By keeping his arms moving efficiently, Bolt maximizes his forward momentum and reduces any unnecessary drag or resistance. Finally, endurance. Bolt wasn't just fast over short distances. He maintained his top speed over the entire 100 meters and 200 meters, which is incredibly challenging. To achieve this, he had to balance speed with endurance. Bolt's training included a lot of interval work, which helped him build up the stamina needed to keep up his high speeds throughout the race. His ability to maintain speed is also a testament to his body's efficiency and the effectiveness of his training. He could sustain a near maximal pace longer than most sprinters, which allowed him to finish strong even when the race was nearly over. In essence, Bolt's sprinting techniques are a combination of a powerful start, efficient running form, and remarkable speed endurance. His ability to get off the blocks quickly gave him a crucial edge, while his running form ensured he used every ounce of his speed effectively, and his endurance allowed him to keep up that incredible pace from start to finish. All these elements together made Bolt not just fast, but unbeatable in his prime. Now, all in all, Usain Bolt's impact on sprinting is nothing short of revolutionary. First off, Bolt's list of world records is simply legendary. He set the world record for the 100 meters with an astonishing time of 9.58 seconds at the 2009 Berlin World Championships. Just a year earlier, he had broken his own record with a time of 9.69 seconds at the Beijing Olympics. Then, in Berlin, he took things to a whole new level. And let's not forget about his 200 meters record. Bolt ran 19.19 seconds in Berlin, shattering the previous record and further solidifying his dominance. These records aren't just numbers. They represent a new standard in sprinting that few have come close to matching. Bolt's achievements extend beyond just breaking records. At the Olympics, he won gold medals in the 100 meters, 200 meters, and 4x100 meters relay in three consecutive games: Beijing 2008, London 2012, and Rio 2016. So what does all this mean in the context of sprinting history? Bolt's records and victories have set a benchmark that will inspire sprinters for generations. His ability to push the boundaries of what was thought possible has changed the way people view the sport. It's not just about being fast anymore. It's about being extraordinary in ways that Bolt has shown us are possible. Globally, Bolt has influenced the sport by drawing more attention to sprinting. Before his rise, sprinting was already popular, but Bolt brought it into the spotlight like never before. His success has led to increased interest in track and field, bringing more fans to the sport and encouraging more young people to take up running. As we look ahead, it's exciting to think about how the world of sprinting is evolving. With advancements in training techniques and technology, the future of the sport holds some incredible possibilities. First up, let's talk about how training has advanced. Nowadays, athletes have access to highly specialized training programs that are tailored to their individual needs. Coaches use sophisticated data analysis to monitor every aspect of a sprinter's performance, from their speed and power to their recovery times. This means that training can be more precise and effective than ever before. For instance, advancements in sports science have led to new methods for improving explosive power and speed endurance, allowing sprinters to push their limits even further. Technology is also playing a huge role. Wearable devices and motion capture systems help athletes and coaches analyze their biomechanics in real time. This data can pinpoint areas for improvement, such as optimizing stride length or perfecting running form. Innovations like smart track surfaces, which can measure an athlete's impact and provide instant feedback, are making training sessions more productive. Additionally, advancements in recovery techniques like cryotherapy and advanced physiotherapy help sprinters bounce back faster and stay at peak performance. With all these advancements, who are the emerging stars who might continue Usain Bolt's legacy? One name that often comes up is Arion Knighton. This young American sprinter has already shown tremendous potential. Knighton burst onto the scene with impressive performances in the 200 meters and has been compared to Bolt in terms of his raw speed and talent. His progress in recent years suggests he could be a major force in sprinting's future. Another promising athlete is Noah Lyles, also from the United States. Lyles has already made a name for himself with strong performances in the 200 meters and 100 meters. Outside the U.S., there are sprinters like Letsile Tebogo from Botswana, who are also showing great promise. Tebogo's performances in the 100 meters and 200 meters have caught the attention of the track and field community, and he could be a key figure in the future of sprinting. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more content like this, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. We'd love to hear your thoughts on Bolt's impact and who you think might be the next big star of sprinting. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.